Hello everyone, on behalf of Rainbow Loom, this is Angeline, formerly known as Tutorials by A here on YouTube. Today, I'm here to show you how to create this bloom ring. Not too long ago, I uploaded a tutorial here on how to create the starburst ring, which is basically this ring without these petal bands. If you're a beginner, I'll link that tutorial in the description box below as it's a great place to start before making this ring. This is a beginner to intermediate level design as we have to do a few unconventional hooking steps to make these petal bands here, but overall, I would still consider this design relatively simple. I especially love this ring because you can position the petals like this and make them stand up, which I think is cool, looks kind of like a buttercup. Or you can lay them flat, so that way you get this nice bold look. Before we get started, let me know in the comments below what you think of this ring and if you'd like to see more ring designs like this. And now without further ado, let's get started. To make this bloom ring today, I'll be using the Rainbow Loom Bracelet Making Kit. This is currently a Walmart exclusive and I will link it in the description box below if you'd like to shop this kit. It of course comes with instructions, as well as this really cute rainbow shaped storage case. Inside of this kit, we have one rainbow loom, two hooks, 1200 bands, 50 beads, and 50 C clips. This kit comes with everything you'll need to make this bloom ring. You'll need a loom, a hook, C clips, and rubber bands. The rubber band counts for this ring are 12 to 14 for the ring portion, which is this white right here. You'll need an additional 7 for the inner portion of the ring, which is this translucent white color here. And you'll need 6 more bands for the petals on the outside here. On this ring right here, I used RainbowLoom.com's limited edition rubber bands. They're a little bit of a different shape than the typical rubber band, so that's why this ring might look a little bit different. Before we start placing our bands, I'm going to make sure that my loom is oriented correctly. At the bottom here, you should have an arrow pointing up that says the number 1, and your pins are in a U-shape orientation. We'll start by doing this chain first, and then this circle that kind of borders the inside here, and then we'll do the other arm of the ring after that. You'll take one band at a time, and I'm placing my first one at this bottom center pin and extending it up one to the pin above. Then taking my next band, we'll go vertically again from the next pin up to the pin above, and then one more time with this same band going from this pin up one more. So now we have a total of 3 rubber bands going vertically up this center row of pins. Now taking my next band, we'll start placing the border on this circle in the center here. So I'm taking one rubber band, placing it on this center pin here, and extending it up one to the left. We'll do the same thing on the right side, taking one band, placing it on that same pin, and then going up to the right instead this time. Now we'll go vertically on each side, so taking one band, going up one here, and one more band, going up one on the right side. Now we'll close off this hexagon, so I'll take one orange rubber band and go from the left up to the center, and then we'll do the same thing on the right side, from the right up to the top center. Now, like I mentioned earlier in the supplies needed portion, you can use 12 to 14 rubber bands for this part. So far, we've used 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Depending on how big or small you want your ring to be, you can use less or more rubber bands. For my fingers, I have a pretty small adult finger, and I used 3 here, like we've done, and then I'll do 3 more chains here for this next arm. So we'll go vertically once here, and now a second time, and then one more time for my finger. So now at this point, your loom should look like this, and we'll start adding the bands to the center now. So I'm going to push these down to make room for my next layer, and now we'll place the bands that are this translucent white color here, and blue and yellow here. For this portion, I think I'll do yellow and blue again. So I'm gonna take my first color, and I'm going to place it from this bottom pin of the hexagon up one to the center. All of these bands will kind of be going from the center out to these pins here on the outside. So my next band, I'll switch to blue now, is gonna go on the left diagonally here. And now for our next band, I'll take yellow again and we'll go diagonally this way. Then switching back to blue, I'm gonna go vertically now. Then switching back to yellow, go diagonal to the right, and then my last band will be blue. I'm gonna go diagonally like this. So now you should have your bands placed like this. And we'll go ahead and add our petal bands on now. You can also vary the colors of your petal bands like I did on this one, but for this step, I'm just gonna use pink. So you're gonna take your first band of your petal color, and we're gonna simply place it on this bottom left pin here of the hexagon. So I'm gonna just drop it there for now. Then taking my next band, I'm gonna go vertically from that same pin that I dropped that band on, and then up one. Then I'm gonna go diagonally from the last pin I ended on up to the top of the hexagon. And then we'll go down here, and we're basically just gonna outline this hexagon with our pink bands. This is the last petal band that I'll place. And then to close this off, we're gonna go back to this one that we left loose right here. So I'm gonna reach over and grab this loose band here, and I'm gonna pull it onto the bottom pin, like that. So now we've connected the whole hexagon together. And at this point, your loom should look like this, and we're now ready to rotate it 180 degrees. Now at the bottom of your loom, you should have an arrow pointing up that says the number 2. The last bands that we'll add are our cap bands. This hook in this kit has a cap band applicator at the end. If you don't have this, you can simply add a cap band on to your pins by doubling it over on whatever pin we're adding it on by hand. The first cap band we'll add on is to this bottom center pin here. I'm gonna take one band of the same color, but you can use a different color if you would like. We're gonna take the end of this hook and wrap this band around it once, twist, and then double it over so that way it's wrapped on here 2 times. Then we'll place this hook onto whatever pin we want to transfer the cap band onto and slide it down onto the pin like that. If you don't have this hook, then you'll simply take your single rubber band, wrap it around the pin once, twist, and then around a second time. The next cap band we'll add on is to the center of our hexagon here. You can do whatever color you'd like. It won't really show unless you have clear bands that are in the center. I'm just gonna use yellow for this, so I'm gonna wrap this around like that, place it on this center pin, and then slide down. Again, you can add this by hand if you would like. It's just a single band doubled over onto this center pin. And now we're ready to start the hooking process. The first bands we'll hook are up here in this hexagon. Just as a note for reference, we will not be hooking the petal bands that we added on. So for me, my petal bands are pink. They're the last set of bands that we added on in a circle around this way. So we won't be hooking any of these. You're just gonna leave those there, because as you can see, these bands are not hooked on this ring. It just loops like that. So the first thing we'll do is hook inside this hexagon. I'm gonna be doing the blue and yellow bands in here. The first band that we'll hook is the one that's going diagonally to this top left pin up here. So for me, it's this blue one. We're gonna go inside the cap band. So there's 2 layers up here that are the cap band. For me, they're yellow. And we'll grab the next band, which is this blue one here that's gonna go up diagonally to the left like this. The next band we'll hook is this yellow one here. We're going to go in a counterclockwise motion, hooking each of these bands as we go. So we're gonna do this yellow one next. I'm gonna go inside the top 2 layers here, which are my cap band, and grab the next one. Remove this from the pin and then fold it over onto its respective pin. The next band that we'll do is this blue one, and we'll hook it down. So I'm gonna go inside this pin, and this one is a little bit trickier to grab, so I'm gonna go inside this cap band, push the 2 layers back, and I'm gonna grab this blue one from the side here. As I grab it from the side, I'm gonna remove it from this top center pin and then move it to the lower pin down here. Now for the next one is this yellow one. I'm gonna grab this yellow and hook it down like this. The next one is this blue one here. So we'll go inside here, grab the blue, hook it upwards to the top right. And our last one is this yellow one going vertically. So I'll grab this and hook it upwards to the top like that. So now that we've finished hooking the inner center of our hexagon, we're gonna do a small little step before we start doing the orange bands or the border bands here. So we're not necessarily hooking the petal bands, but we're gonna flip them out of the way for a moment. So I'm gonna grab this left one here on the bottom left this outside edge of it. Don't grab the inside one right here, but this outer one here. And with this left one, I'm gonna grab it and just flip it over the bottom center pin of this hexagon. And release, like that. And we'll do the same thing on this right side here. Flip it over this bottom center one, like that. And now we're ready to move on to hooking our orange bands at the bottom here. So starting with this bottom center pin here, I'm gonna go inside the top two layers here, which are the cap band, and grab the bottom one, which is the third one, and hook this upwards. Moving to our next one, I'll go inside of this pin here, grab our next band, and hook it upwards. And then going inside this same pin here, hooking this band upwards one. So now we should have something like this. At this point, we'll put back the petal bands that we have flipped out of the way. So we're gonna flip them back over. I'm gonna push these pins down, or the bands down, on this bottom pin of the hexagon to make room. Then I'm gonna grab the right one first, and it's this bottom horizontal layer here that's pink for my petal band, and I'm gonna flip it back over this bottom center pin of the hexagon. So it should look like what it did before. And we'll do the same thing to the left side now, grabbing this portion of this petal band that we flipped over and pulling it back over this bottom center pin of the hexagon. Now we'll continue with hooking our orange border bands. So I'm gonna go inside this bottom center pin first, push back all of these layers inside of this pin here. Make sure you're not going from in here, but wanna go inside of this pin here. Grab the top orange layer, which is gonna be our band going to the left. Like that. Next, we'll do this right side one. So I'm going inside all these layers again, grabbing the very bottom one now, pulling it off of the pin and up to this one on the right. We'll do the orange ones going vertically on each side now, so I'm just gonna do the left side first, reaching in through all of these layers, pushing them back out of the way with the back of my hook. And I'll grab this bottom one here. There's a lot of tension there, so don't force anything, just get it up to that pin, and if it's caught on anything because of the tension, you can run your hook around this pin to kind of release it. Now we'll do the same thing on the right side, so reaching in through all these layers and pushing them back with the back of my hook. I'll grab the bottom band and hook it upwards to the pin above. Now we'll do the bands that are going diagonally into this top center pin. So I'm gonna go inside this top left pin here, push all these bands out of the way that I don't want, and grab this bottom layer, which is orange, and then I'll hook this up to this top center pin. Same thing on the right side, going in through all of these layers and pushing what I don't want out of the way, and grabbing this band and hooking it up to the top center of the hexagon. Now we'll do a small step with moving our pink petal bands out of the way again on this top pin this time. So I'm gonna do the right side first. We're gonna grab this right side petal band right here. So you don't want to go inside through here and then grab this pink petal band. You want to reach in from the outside here and grab it right here. Then we'll pull this over and flip it over this top center pin of the hexagon. And we'll do the same thing on the left side with this petal band here. Pull it up over this top center pin of the hexagon. Now we'll finish off the rest of this chain that's going vertically here. So I'm going to reach inside through all these layers, push this back, and grab the very bottom layer, and then hook this upwards. And again, there's a lot of tension on this pin, so don't pull too hard because you might break your band. But after that, you can run this around and release some of the tension, and just pull really slow when you're pulling up here. I'll do the next chain here, and then my final chain here. And here is my loom now. Now I'll just grab my C-clip, and I'm gonna grab the two layers that are on this top center pin here with my C-clip. So I'll scoop them up here, and you should be able to pull on the C-clip, and it should be pulling all of the layers on this top pin here. If it's not, then go ahead and grab whatever layers you're missing, and then once you've got all of them, you're safe to pull this off of your loom. Might look a little bit wonky, so you can give it a little tug to even out all the rubber bands here. The side that these pink bands are sticking up on is the front, so I'm gonna flip it over to the back. Then on whatever side that the C-clip is not on, I'm gonna find our cap band, which is this little doubled over band that should look like two little circles. And I'm gonna add these two circles into my C-clip on the other end. So that way we now have this bloom ring. So cute, and I'm so excited with how my color combo turned out. Thank you all so much for watching this tutorial on how to create the bloom ring. If you enjoyed it, don't forget to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel for more fun tutorials like this. The supplies I used today can be found in the description box below. I will link this kit so that way you can shop it at walmart.com if you'd like. And also, our social media sites are linked in the description box as well. We post tons of fun creations, and we also love to reshare whatever you post on Instagram and TikTok to the hashtag RainbowLoom. And just to be sure that we don't miss any of your posts, we'd love to be tagged as well at this username. That is it for this video. Thanks so much for watching, and I look forward to seeing you in Rainbow Loom's next tutorial next week. Bye!